स्टैंडर्ड 9th. टुडे वी विल रिवाइज चैप्टर 9th, एक्सरसाइज 9A. बिफोर स्टार्टिंग द एक्सरसाइज वी विल लर्न अबाउट द बेसिक्स ऑफ दिस चैप्टर. दिस चैप्टर इज बेस्ड ऑन ट्रायंगल्स. नाउ व्हाट डू यू मीन बाय ट्रायंगल? एनी ऑफ द थ्री साइडेड क्लोज्ड फिगर मेड बाय स्ट्रेट लाइंस इज नोन एज ट्रायंगल. इन अ ट्रायंगल देयर आर थ्री एंगल्स एंड थ्री वर्टिसेस. इफ वी ड्रॉ or if we join the midpoint of one side to its opposite vertex, this line segment is known as median. So in triangle ABC, BD is the median. Like this, in a triangle there are three medians and all three pass through the same point, that's why they are concurrent. So this common point, what you will say, it will be known as centroid. This we learn about median. Now secondly, about altitude or perpendicular or the height of the triangle. Any triangle is given. In a triangle, the perpendicular drawn from a vertex, any of the vertex on the opposite side, is known as its altitude, perpendicular or height. Means it will make 90 degree angle, but here D is not a midpoint. In a triangle, there are three altitude. All the three altitude pass through the same point, and this point, common point, is known as orthocenter. This we learn about triangles. Now, basically, this chapter is based on congruency of triangles. Now, what do you mean by congruency? Congruency means when a thing cover others, another one exactly as my hands. Or the pages of this book, one page cover another page from each and every angle exactly. So they are congruent to each other. Now we are talking about triangles. Congruency of triangle. There are different properties or axioms. So accordingly, if in a triangle, if all three sides are equal, then which property we will follow? Side means, in short form we can write as SSS, congruency. The second one, in a pair of triangles, if two sides and including angle, this is equal, then you can see from the diagram side, angle, side. So this is the second one. Now third one, two triangles are given. If in these two triangles, two angles and the side where these both the angles are made, if they are equal, then angle, side, angle property we will follow and triangles will be congruent. Now, if any of the two triangles are equal, in two triangles, means two angles are given equal, so automatically the third angle will be equal to third. Why? Because sum of the angles is 180. If we separate, we get the same. If in any of a triangle like this, two angles and side. So here angle, angle, side also we can say. Otherwise you find the third angle by angle sum property of triangle, then it will be angle, side, angle. So you can take angle, angle, side. The last one is RHS, means right angle, hypotenuse, one side. If any of two triangles are right means 90 degree angle is given, that means one angle is 90. Hypotenuse is the side which is opposite to right angle. If hypotenuse are same and one of the side, it can be perpendicular or it can be base, then we follow right hand side property. Now after proving this, any of these triangles congruent from any of the identity, then rest of the part, what? If three sides are equal, then by congruency rule, the angles, corresponding angles, angle A will be equal to angle B, B will be equal to C, like this, angles will be equal and we can find rest of the parts also. Now we will start our exercise 9A. Third question. In this question, one circle is given and its chord is given AB. OP is perpendicular. You have to prove AP is equal to PB. To prove AP is equal to PB, what we will do? We have to join OA with OB to make triangle, because this is a chapter based on triangle. So we do construction, join OA and OB. We join them. Like this we get two triangles. So proof. In triangle OAP or OPA, it's your choice. And triangle OPB. Now what things are common? Which property we will follow? We have to see now. OA is equal to OB. Why? Because they both are radii. We know that radii are of the same circle. They are equal. So the reason is radii. The second one, OP is equal to OB, because this OP is coming in this triangle also and another one also. So this side is common. The third thing, angle P equals angle P 90. It is given in the quotient. So see, if you see in the triangle, right angle, half news, one side. So which property we will follow? We will follow by RHS, condition of congruency. Triangle OAP is congruent to triangle OBP. If triangles are congruent, then by CPCTC corresponding parts also congruent. Therefore, AP is equal to PB by CPCTC. Hence proved. Now, next question, question number 6. In this, the perpendicular bisectors are given of a triangle ABC. They all meet at I. You have to prove IA is equal to IB is equal to IC. So, we draw one triangle ABC. In this, AP, BQ and CR are perpendicular bisector. Perpendicular means making angle of 90. That means angle P equals angle Q equals angle R is equal to 90 degree. Secondly, one more word is here, bisector. Bisector means P is the midpoint of BC, Q is midpoint of AC and R is midpoint of AB. So that's why BP is equal to BC, AR is equal to BR and CQ is equal to AQ. You have to prove IA is equal to IB is equal to IC. So we will take now here two triangles. First we will take in triangle BPI or BIP and triangle CIP. BP is equal to PC given, angle P is equal to B 90 degree and IP is equal to IP. It is common. So which property we will follow? We can go by RHS? No, because hypotenuses are not equal. We will go side angle side. Therefore, by side angle side congruency, triangles are congruent. If triangles are congruent, then corresponding parts will be also equal. Therefore, IB equals IC by CPCTC. Similarly, we take to these two triangles, you can prove also, otherwise you can write similarly. Triangle AIQ is congruent to triangle CIQ So in this triangle, when triangles are congruent, IA is equal to IC by CP CTC. Now we compare these two. We can give it number 1, you can name it as number 2. From first and second, IA equals IB equals IC, hence proved. This only you have to prove. Now, next question, 10th. In this question, we have a figure. Figure is given. In this, AB is equal to BD, AC is given equal to DC, and angle ABD, ABD, this full angle is given 58, full angle. And then angle DBC, DBC, this angle value is given. Angle DCB, DCB, this is given 63. So these few particular things are given here. You have to find value of x and y. Solution. First of all, we'll take these two triangles. We prove them congruent. If we prove them congruent, then automatically by CPCTC, these angles will be equal to each other, and then we substitute the value and calculate. In triangle ABC and triangle DBC, because see, you have to see, not DCB. You have to take that angle such as if you cover or if you fold these triangles, then B will cover B and C will cover C. What is common between these two triangles? AB equals BD, it is given. BC equals BC, common. AC equals CD, this is also given. Now all the three sides are equal. Which property we will follow? By which one? Side, side, side. So by side, 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 condition of congruency of triangles. Triangles are congruent. If triangles are congruent, then by CPCTs, these angles will be also equal. So therefore, angle ABC equals angle DBC by CPCTC. But sum of these two angles is given 58, as angle ABC plus angle DBC equals angle ABD. Now you can substitute them. Angle ABC plus angle ABC is equal to 58. Twice of angle ABC equals 58. From here you can find value of ABC is 29. That means they both are 29 and 29. That means angle ABC equals angle DBC equals 29. But in question, value is given DBC. DBC is given 2x minus 4. But 2x minus 4. So here angle DBC we can substitute as 29. That means 29 plus 4, 33 is 2x. 2x is, so x is equal to 33 over 2, means x is equal to, you divide them, 16.5 degree. So x value we have found. Now we have to find value of y. Angle DCB is given 63. And angle ACB is given y plus 15. We know that these both angles are equal by CPCTC. Also, angle ACB equals angle DCB by C. CPCPC. But what is angle ACB? Substitute from question y plus 15. What is value of angle DCB? 63. So from here y is equal to 63 minus 15, 48 degree. Like this you can find out value of x and value of y. Now next question 14. In this question we have a triangle. In this triangle AB is given equal to AC and AD is perpendicular to BC. That means this angle D is 90. What more is given? BE bisect angle B. That means angle 1 equals angle 2. You can number it, otherwise you have to read like this BED or any of the name. One more thing is given in this question. EF is perpendicular to AB. Yes. So this is 90. You have to prove BD is equal to CD. Means these two parts you have to prove equal. Secondly, you have to prove ED is equal to EF. ED is equal to EF. To prove first part, what we will do? We will take these two triangles ABD and ACD. Now, which three things are common here? We need three things equal here. The first one, AB is equal to AC. It is given in the question. Secondly, AD is common. The third thing, angle D is equal to D, 90. So, which property we will follow here? 90, one side and hypotenuse, that means RHS. By RHS, condition of congruency, triangle ABD is congruent to triangle ACD. Now we have proved these two triangles are congruent. Then corresponding parts will be equal. So BD equals BC by CPCPC. So our first part we have solved. Now for second part, you have to solve ED is equal to EF. Means these two triangles we have to take now. In triangle EFB and triangle EDB. Here this side is common. BE equals BE. It is common because this side is in both the triangles. The second thing is angle 1 is equal to 2 as BE bisect angle, because BE bisects angle B. The third thing, these two angles are of 90 degree, means angle F equals angle D is 90 degree. So which property we will follow here? We will follow angle side. Therefore, by angle side, condition of congruency, triangles are congruent. If triangles are congruent, then by CPCPC, EF will be equal to ED. Hence, proved. So remaining part also you try with the same properties.